Hello everyone and welcome. Today, I'm here with Doris Tan, Head of Shell Aviation, Asia Pacific and Middle East. Thank you for taking the time to speak to us today, Doris.
Hi Hanwei, happy to be here.
You know, when people think about Shell, aviation doesn't come to mind immediately. Can you tell me a little bit more about what we do in aviation in Shell?
Yes, you're right, Hanwei. The first association people have with us is probably with our mobility business due to the visibility of our service station network. But in reality, we are known for providing quality fuel throughout the history of Shell. It is as much about keeping planes in the sky as much as fueling vehicles on the ground. For over 100 years, Shell has been powering flights, supplying jet fuel to aviation's pioneers for generations. In 1909, we were there to supply fuel to Louis Blériot's first flight across the English Channel. In the 1930s, we were also there to set up the refueling network for the first flights out of Europe to Singapore. Fast forward to today, we've built an extensive global network that covers key airports across the world.
Doris, to talk about global, what about aviation in Singapore?
Hanwei, you know I'm a Singaporean, so Singapore has a very special place in my heart. It is a wonderful place and of great importance to Shell Aviation as a key hub in the Asia Pacific region. What I'm most pleased about is what we are doing to push forward the future of aviation at Changi International Airport. In 2022, we upgraded our facility here in Singapore to enable the blending of sustainable aviation fuel, SAF. So we became the first jet supplier to supply sustainable aviation fuel right here in Singapore, helping our customers decarbonize when they depart from this country. Our SAF footprint in Asia Pacific and Middle East has also expanded to Hong Kong International Airport and most recently to Dubai International Airport. And right here in Singapore, we also work with our traders to create opportunities to source from a wide range of suppliers and deliver to our customers worldwide. Our capabilities as a blender, trader, transporter, together with our innovation and marketing expertise, is what we seek as a leverage to continue to deliver fuels and lubricants to our customers here. This will put us in a very unique position to help meet the challenge of the energy reality.
Let's talk a little bit about the energy transition. How is it a challenge here? What is the state of sustainability in aviation right now?
Oh, Hanwei, I don't have to tell you how difficult it is to decarbonize the aviation sector. It is one of the key challenges for the industry. Aviation plays a vital role in connecting people and transporting medicines and other goods around the world. Currently, it is accounting for about 3% of global emissions, according to IATA data. But this could rise to 22% if nothing is done about it by 2050. From what I've seen so far, the industry must and can meet the long-term aspirations of ICAO's net zero by 2050.
Doris, what are some of the solutions available to us to meet this goal?
There are various options available to us today and into the future to help our customers avoid, reduce and compensate their emissions. In the long term, electric and hydrogen-powered aircraft have the potential to be used in smaller aircraft for short and medium-haul flights, but it takes time to develop. Right now, SAF is the only viable in-sector scalable option that we have to materially reduce emissions from flying in the 2050 timeframe. As such, carbon credits or offsets have an immediate role to play during the time it takes to develop and scale up other ways to decarbonize the sector.
SAF is undeniably part of the solution. Why isn't SAF used in every plane today? What are some of the challenges regards to SAF?
At the moment, SAF only accounts for a very small proportion of the global jet fuel supply, only 0.2% in 2023. And this is because the market is yet to mature and there are still complexities in its supply chain.
Oh, Doris, this sounds like a chicken and egg problem. High cost keeping demand low. To bring down costs, supply needs to go up. But supply can only increase when there's more demand.
Exactly right, Hanwei. So to overcome the price premium, everyone in the aviation value chain needs to come together to collaborate. And that is from the airlines to the fuel suppliers, to the OEMs, to the policy makers. Alongside others in the sector, Shell is advocating for governments around the world and at ICAO to enable the increase in SAF use through globally aligned regulations.
Doris, you mentioned policy makers. What can governments do?
With effective policy framework in place, we can drive up the demand of SAF as a solution to materially reduce emissions from flying. For instance, right here in Singapore, the Singapore government is introducing a SAF levy for flights departing Singapore from 2026. This levy is initially set to target 1% of total aviation fuel used in Singapore. and it will increase to between 3 and 5% by 2030.
That is a great example of governments giving guidance early and clearly, similar to the mandates in Europe.
I must emphasize that for mandates to be effective, it should be introduced alongside with incentives. We want the policy to both provide a carrot and a stick.
I completely agree. Guidance from policymakers is absolutely important. But let us not forget about voluntary demand. Can you give me an example of what Shell is doing to scale demand and supply?
Yes, of course. We've been doing a range of things to scale up the demand and supply of SAF. For example, in 2022, alongside Accenture and Amex GBT, we launched our book and claim platform, Avilia. Avilia allows airlines and corporate customers seeking to use SAF in their air transportation needs to contribute towards the SAF premium and collectively claim their respective Scope 1 and 3 environmental benefits respectively. This is possible even if SAF is not available in their departure airports.
Sounds like book and claim is indeed a solution for airlines as well as their aviation customers, be it corporate travellers or air cargo players.
Yes, the response from customers have been very encouraging. So far, we have signed over 30 agreements with customers from various sectors. Under these agreements, Shell Aviation has already injected 10 million gallons of SAF into the existing global fuel network at airports around the world. All in all, I'm really happy with what we've achieved with our forward-looking customers thus far, and I'm excited about what we can do as an industry through the portfolio of our decarbonisation solutions. Let's collaborate and work towards aviation ambition of net zero by 2050.
Doris, as usual, thank you so much for your time and sharing these valuable insights with us on aviation in Singapore as well as globally.
Thank you.